may know, one of the most eagerly anticipated matches will be occurring this weekend when the Honky Tonk Man defends his title against the former champ Randy Macho Man Savage. To discuss this great matchup, joining me now, the managers. First of all, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. And, of course, the lovely Elizabeth. All right. Jimmy, what about this matchup?
Well, first of all, baby, me and the Honky Tonk Man, Daddy, we ain't worried about nothing.
You're not worried about putting the title on the line? You could lose this thing.
Well, first of all, you got to look at the man, baby, that manages the Honky Tonk Man. Do you know any other person that manages more than one champion, Daddy, besides the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart?
All right, Jimmy Hart says he's not too concerned. Elizabeth, are you concerned about the matchup?
Well, of course I'm concerned. I want him to win, but most of all, I'm worried about his safety.
Well, let me tell you something, baby. You better be concerned over him, because I promise you this, we're going to humiliate the Macho Man. And before it's all over, we might play a little tune on him. You know what I mean, man?
I'll tell you something, Mouth of the South. You have had a lot to say on this subject.
Well, yes, Jimmy Hart has had a lot to say. And yes, the Honky Tonk Man has had a lot to say. But after this match is over, they both could be eating their words.
Dog Man beats Elizabeth's Randy Macho Man Savage.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. About to enter the ring, introducing first the manager, Oliver Humperdinck. And he represents, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Orndorff, visiting monthly
from Steamboat Springs, Colorado, weighing 285 pounds, Dave Wagner.
Wagner, 285, big boy. Bobby the Brain Heenan had a few choice words, apparently, for Paul Orndorff a little earlier. Here's what Bobby the Brain had to say.
Boy, oh boy, Mr. Wonderful, you think you are so great. You think you look so good. Well, this week, I've got a surprise for you, pal, because I'm going to embarrass you. I'm going to make you bury your head in sand. You're going to look so bad when you get through and you see what I've got in store for you, Mr. Wonderful.
What do you think he has in store for him?
I don't know, but you can bet if what Bobby Heenan promises, he delivers. So I have no idea what Heenan has in store for him. But it'll be good, I'm sure.
Orndorff with Wagner. Throws him to the outside, goes out right after it. Orndorff with Wagner, what's he going to do now? Ooh, with a clip, I believe, into the throat area. Well, when you sign on for a match for this man, you've signed on for something.
Well, to me, Mr. Wonderful's a confused man. What he wants, he don't know what kind of manager he wants. He don't know if he wants to be liked or disliked or whatever.
Wait a minute,
what's going on here?
From the far side of the arena. What's that?
That's Ravishing Rick Rude, Bobby the Brain.
Orndorff in the ring with Wagner. I'm too sure to Paul Orndorff is.
Oh, look at that body on Rick.
Knows what's going on behind him.
I don't think Orndorff wants to look. Look at the build on Rick Rude. This guy's ripped.
Heenan certainly delivered. He said he was going to have a surprise for Orndorff. I assume this is what he meant.
Wow. Orndorff took one look over there. He's looking over there.
Orndorff really in control of this match. An attempted cover. We have two.
No. Look at that. And he picked him up. He could have pinned him.
series of poses.
Whoa, look at that guy.
I think Orndorff is concentrating on this match against Dave Wagner. He's doing a number on it. I think he's even noticed that Rick moves around.
I personally think Orndorff's embarrassed by Rick Rude.
I don't think so at all. I think Orndorff has done an excellent job of paying attention to this matchup.
Absolutely. Ooh, wow. He's concentrating on the match and doing quite a number on Dave Wagner.
He has Wagner in position. Scoops him up, and what's going to happen? What a cover. And a three count.
But does he want a piece of Rick Rude? I don't think so.
Here is your winner, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Orndorff victorious. Rick Rude continuing to flash poses at Orndorff. Wait a minute, I think now Orndorff can direct the attention towards Mr. Rude.
I think he just noticed him for the first time right now.
Let's see how Orndorff is going to handle this. Is saying, all right, Rick Rude, look at this.
There we go. Well, it's all posing in the ring.
Here's something very special in the way of information about the World Wrestling Federation. Here we go.
Bobby Heenan, you probably felt that I was finished from professional wrestling once and for all. But that, unfortunately for you, the tricep tendon was disassociated from the joint. The tricep heads were disassociated from the tendon sheath, but the doctor successfully repaired it 110%. And he gave me his word that I will be back, bigger and stronger than ever. And in a few days, this cast will come off, and I will be training again, and I will be back to eliminate you and the rest of your Goon Squad from the World Wrestling Federation once and for all.
Coming towards the ring, at a total combined weight of 540 pounds, from Charlotte, North Carolina, the Junkyard Dog. And his partner from Krakow, Poland, Ivan Hutchke.
The Polish power.
Is that who I think it is?
Their opponent, the war total combined weight of 500 pounds, from Chicago, Illinois, Mike Polan. His partner from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, Chris Curtis.
You know what's unique about this tag team, McMahon, the JYD and Paduski?
That's Butsky.
Paduski. If you took both of them and added their IQs up, I don't believe you could reach triple figures.
That's not a very kind thing to say.
I'm not a very kind person, especially when Ivan the Wart's around. I thought I battered him out of wrestling.
Not by a long shot. The Dog dumping Curtis down the canvas, scoops him up, now dumps him again. Dog down on all fours. Curtis brings a headbutt by the Junkyard Dog. Oh, Putzke now dropping as well. Colin, and look at this. Putzke and the Dog pretty much cleaning house in there.
You know, the only saving grace on Paduski is?
That's Putzke.
When he slams you, you're only coming down from 4.5 feet.
Yes, but just think about the power that he puts behind that slam. As a matter of fact, it's Polish power. Earlier on, we had an occasion to chat with Ivan Putzke, and I believe he was teaching the Junkyard Dog, giving a little Polish lesson, I believe.
Well, this ought to be great.
No, I'm not ready.
Tell the people what I told you, what the Polish fire has taught you. Come on, Dog.
Oh, okay, Puss. Yashimash, Puske.
All right.
You're looking dober, baby.
All right. You see that? We're going to make it, baby. Right, you
right,
and I, dude.
All right, all right.
And you,
all
partner, right. We're going to get him. Yeah. Right, Dog?
Yeah.
What do you say?
Dobra.
All right, Dobra. Little knocker there. Ivan Putski.
I got to give him this, though. The Wart's always in great shape.
He looks great.
Oh!
Lutsky looks as good as I've ever seen him.
But I'll say one thing. I bet if you ask Peduzzi, he'd never want to arm wrestle me again.
Why not, Jesse?
Oh, what a lesson I taught him a few years back.
Yeah, you sure did. Look at this. Putski, let's go. Flexing the pack. Ivan Putski does look great. Tag is made here. And the junk drop dog with a headbutt. Fallon having his problems now. Whips in a rope. Here comes the dog right at him. Ooh.
Whoa. I'll tell you that JYD's looking as big as I've ever seen him
He's
before.
He's a big house, isn't he?
Paduski looks like he's going to set up for the Polish hammer.
On the rope, yes, right into the chest area.
There's
the cover. Referee.
Two.
For the three count. Headbutt by the one. Ivan Putski in the judge eye dog. Polish power. Let's go back to the replay.
Boy, Putski and Junkyard really made a powerful team over here as we see Putski ready to deliver his Polish hammer. Bam! With as much devastation as ever. And here's the pin. An easy victory.
Ivan Putski victorious. Let's check it out to a most interesting
issue of the WWF magazine features you in a full-color sweater is a big article. You know, it's about time that the WWF, they finally recognize the talent of the Big Elbow. You know, but it just goes to prove things always. They've never, and I repeat, never been anything ever given to the Big Elbow. That's why I just go out there and I reach, and I take it, and I make it for myself. But you don't know then that I have done it, that I am on the road. I'm just like a big old stampede with those Texas Longhorns. There ain't nothing, nowhere, nobody that's gonna stop me, you understand?
Hold on one second, Mr. Bennett.
No, you won't.
I know the pictures were very impressive, not gonna doubt that, but did you see what the writing said?
What are you talking about?
They called you a bushwhacker.
Well, I tell you what, you have been called a bushwhacker. Mind you, it might have some effect on other people, but it depends on your definition. You know, a lot of people think that a bushwhacker is somebody who hides in the weeds, becomes to jump somebody from behind. Do I look like the type of person that's going to come and jump you from behind? No! I'm going to look you eyeball to eyeball. I'm going to come and I'm going to do my utmost most to get you in the ring, people. Now I want to know, where is the competition going to come from? Miss Betsy, she's getting a little bit empty. She wants to feel so much scared. She wants to feel somebody's back. Let me tell you something. Hogan, how about you, Duggan? Santana, how about all you guys? You kind of hide in the weeds. You play a little bushwhacking yourself, ain't you? Well, come out. The Big Outlaw's here. I'm looking at eyeball to eyeball. No bushwhacking here. Straight out, one-on-one. Come and get it.
Oh, yeah. The big match this weekend. Honky Tonk Man after Macho Madness. Yeah. Get so hold of you. You're not going to be able to sing, yeah. And you're not going to be able to dance. You're going to feel real bad. A Macho Madness hangover, yeah.
You've been saying I had a big mouth, well, you're right. But you're not going to shut it for me, because I'm going to sing, I'm going to dance, and after this weekend when I shake, rattle, and roll you, I'm going to prove to everybody, and you in particular, Macho Man, I'm the greatest intercontinental heavyweight champion of all time, the Honky Tonk Man.
Skimmy night, the World Wrestling Federation presents a special live pay-per-view event. Witness the Survivor Series. The most spectacular lineup in wrestling history will make this November 26th Thanksgiving night a night to remember. Hulk Hogan's team is led by the world's heavyweight champion himself.
On Thanksgiving night, the WWF is having their first Survivor Series. Andre the Giant, your team versus mine. One by one, they'll be eliminated until it's just you and me together.
Hulk's teammates are Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, Bam Bam Bigelow, superstar Billy Graham, and the former Olympian Ken Patera. The opposition features Andre the Giant.
I want you, Hulk Hogan.
Andre's team includes Ravishing Rick Rude, One Man Gang, King Kong Bundy, plus the natural Butch Reed. See the Survivor Series this Thanksgiving night.
Well,
contest is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing...
Whoa, watch out, Morocco!
Whoa!
Going right after Cowboy Bobwood! Hammering down! Boy, these two, no love lost whatsoever between these two former tag team partners.
You know, this breaks my heart to see a great tag team end up like this.
Love lost, they hate each other. Look at this, they attacked each other like two mad dogs.
A lot of bad blood here.
Oh, bad blood.
Each one claiming the other one for the demise of the tag team.
They're out to destroy one another. Look at this.
Morocco hammering away Orton to the outside now.
And Orton hit hard outside that ring. I'll tell you, Morocco didn't even let the ring announcer finish his announcements.
The ace predicting victory for himself just last week in this matchup.
Well, I don't think he had any idea Morocco was going to break rules like this.
Oh, I don't know about that. I mean, both of these men have broken, if not bend, rules from time to time.
The ace is a tremendous technician in the ring. The ace, Cowboy Bob Orton, is a wrestler. Morocco
has
Yes, and Morocco has turned this into a blatant street fight. And all Orton can do now is go to the eyes and fight fire with fire.
Ooh.
That's a bunch of nonsense. They both hate each other, and they're both out there for one reason, that is to destroy the other.
And you love it, don't you, Bruno?
Hey, I'm just telling it the way it is. I'm calling it to what I see here, and that's what I'm seeing.
Well, that's a first.
And you're telling us now, Jesse, that you feel sorry, that there's a compassion somewhere in your heart for these two?
Yes, I feel sorry that a great tag team and a great friendship has somehow dissolved and gotten to this point. That's what I feel sorry about. They were a great tag team. And I don't know what caused it. I think maybe Morocco was jealous of Ace Orton's ring capabilities.
Somehow I doubt that. I mean, if anything...
I wouldn't expect anything different.
It had to be Orton who was jealous of Morocco. I mean, look at the way this tank is put together. Oh, look at this. Don't tell me he's going to suplex him all the way out.
No, this will be a first.
My goodness, can't get him up.
He's holding on the ropes. Orton's holding on to the ropes.
Tremendous Morocco reversal.
Wait a minute, they're all locked together.
Who pinned who?
Oh, I thought you pinned who. Morocco pinned Horton. That's what you just saw.
No.
Yes, sir. Boy, did that suplex backfire.
The magnificent Morocco.
I think this is far from over. That was a questionable decision.
Jesse, you're wrong. Morocco gets the dip.
Thank
you now to Craig the George, along with Bobby the Brain Heenan and Andre the Giant.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to my guests. Of course, the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
You know, you can make all the noise you want, but if you're smart, you better listen to what I have to say. This man right here, Andre the Giant, he has not stepped in to a wrestling ring since WrestleMania 3. He has not been in a wrestling ring since he was robbed, and I mean robbed, in the Pontiac Silverdome before the largest crowd in the history of professional sports. Why was he robbed? Because of poor officiating and because of the likes of one man, Hulk Hogan. But what I'm getting down to is, he has told me time and time again he would not step into a wrestling ring unless he could get into the ring with the world heavyweight champion, Hulk Hogan. And I told him, the day will come, the day will come when I make sure that the next time you enter a ring, you will be standing in that ring, and you'll be looking across at the big, tough Hulk Hogan. Well, the day has come. The day has come. And the day will be Thanksgiving night of this year. And they're calling it the Survivor Series. That's right. Get it straight, pal. The Survivor Series. And what it boils down to is an elimination tag team match. Now, Thanksgiving night, Hogan, I don't care who you have in your corner and your ring as tag team partner. You've got superstar Billy Graham. You've got Ken the X-Con Patera. You've got Bam Bam Bigelow. And you've also got Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff. And along with yourself, the heavyweight champion of the world, you think you've got enough backup to survive. Wrong, dummy. Because you know who we got. We've got the natural Butch Reed. We've got close to 480 pounds. The one-man gang. The newest member of the Bobby Heenan family. The greatest athletic physique in the world. Ravishing Rick Rude. And if that's not enough, also close to 480 pounds, King Kong Bundy. And leading this team on Thanksgiving night, leading this match, the Survivor Series, will be this man, the ace wonder of the world, the uncrowned heavyweight champion, Andre the Giant. So what I want Hogan to understand is, during this match, during this elimination match, when they're dropping left and right, and they're going out over here and over there, one time it's gonna happen. This man here is gonna put those giant hands around your neck, Hogan, around your neck, and he's gonna squeeze and squeeze and squeeze. Because Turkey, you better have thanks. Thank your lucky stars that you're the world champion. Because this man, as far as I'm concerned, and everybody's concerned, is gonna get his hands on you, and he is going to literally rip you apart.
Bobby, before you go, I can't let you go without perhaps getting a comment from Andre on this Survivor Series.
You know what? I'm very glad they called that the Survivor Series. I'm going to tell you why. Because Andre the Giant doesn't take survivors. Because Andre the Giant will be the survivor. Yeah. And I promise you that again.
Thanksgiving night. Witness the Survivor Series.
About a new concept in professional wrestling. It's called the Survivor Series, and it will be occurring on this Thanksgiving night. Now, it will be done elimination style with a team format in both the tag team and singles divisions. And there will be a number of elimination matches, including one that everyone is talking about. That one will pit Andre the Giant's team against the world heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan's team. So there will be a tag team division, and with that in mind, I'd like to introduce you to my guest at this time, manager, Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and the world tag team champions, Bret the Hitman Hart, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, the Hart Foundation. And I know you are looking forward to Thanksgiving evening, the Survivor Series, and a great tag team competition.
Let me tell you something, Daddy. We're so excited because we want to prove to everybody that we are the very best. Because you see, in the Survival Series, baby, we are the top team. There's no doubt about it. You've got the Rougeaus. You've got the Killer Bees. You've got the Demolition, the Islanders. You've got the British Bulldogs. But we're going to come out on top, right, baby?
Shut up! The Strike Force. What kind of survivors are these guys? May the Force not be with you. And then we've got the Islanders.
They're just plain dumb.
How many times do we got to beat the Bees? How many times do we got to beat the Bulldogs? We've beaten all these guys. We're the best there is, and there's nothing better. This is the best way to prove it, because we're going to survive. We are the survivors.
We are certainly talking about the best. No question about it in a tag team competition.
Us, right? You're talking about us, the best, right here.
Well, I'm
right here, baby, right here.
We are the survivors, baby.
We are the world tag team champions, and in my opinion, we are the best. But this is going to be our biggest test. Plus, outside the rings, you're going to have some of the greatest minds in professional wrestling. Besides the Mouth of the South, you've got Mr. Fuji. You've got Bobby the Brain Heenan. But we're going to be ready to prove to everybody that we're number one, baby.
All right, looking forward to it, the Survivor Series this Thanksgiving evening.
Myself knows it better. For 4 long years, man, I've been out in that combat zone surviving, man. And it wasn't just a wrestling match every night. Every night, they came for the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight title. Every night, they went for the jugular vein, man. And Survival Series is just exactly what this is. Oh yeah, I survived WrestleMania 3, as controversial as it was. But now in the Survival Series, with Team Elimination, Andre the Giant's team against my team of Hulkamaniacs. One by one, one by one, they'll be eliminated. And I can tell you this, ever since WrestleMania 3, I've heard a day and night about Andre the Giant, that you didn't press him all the way over your head. But I can tell you one thing, I survived WrestleMania 3. I get a decision, a three count in WrestleMania 3. And now Andre the Giant, his team, the whole master plan is to get at me, to get back, to dethrone me. But in the survival series, I can promise you one thing. I'm a survivor. That's the code name around here. And I'm better at it than anybody. And Andre the Giant, in this survival series, we shall meet eye to eye. We shall lock up. And all I got to say is I will survive.
George Animal Steel was originally scheduled to wrestle here this week. However, considering the state of mind he was in, the World Wrestling Federation officials opted not to allow the Animal to wrestle because he was so upset as to what happened to Miss Elizabeth just a couple of weeks ago in the Honky Tonk Savage matchup. So therefore, let's go up to the ring now for this matchup.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my right, the manager, Oliver Humperdinck. He represents from Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. His opponent from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, weighing 264 pounds, Chris Curtis.
Chris Curtis to meet Mr. Wonderful. Now, honestly, Jesse, whom do you feel has the better physique?
Orndorff?
I only answer honestly. Orndorff
or
who?
Or Rick Rude?
Without a doubt, Rick Rude.
Why?
Why? Because he's more chiseled than Mr. Wonderful is. His definition's a little better, and I know about these things. Why don't you ask Bruno? Bruno, I know, has judged some physique contests in his day.
Bruno, what do you think?
Well, I think that Rick Rude's got more of a symmetrical type of physique. But Orndorff has got more of a stocky, rugged-looking physique.
Wait a minute. Look at this. Bobby Heenan there with the man we were speaking of just moments ago.
It looks like we're going to get a first-hand look at who's got the better physique. Look at the build on ravishing Rick Rude. I mean, that guy's ripped. Look at them abs. Look at the serratus.
I want to look at Orndorff's match. That's what I want to look at. I don't want to look at this. Obviously, Rick Rude coming out to distract Paul Orndorff. Hoping it perhaps Orndorff would suffer an upset. Ooh, my.
You know, I think it's more of a possibility that Orndorff, I bet, is ducking Rick Rude. And I'll bet you this is the only way Rude can shame him into getting into the ring.
Well, we've seen this kind of shenanigans before as Orndorff shoves Chris Curtis back to the canvas. Uh-oh, Orndorff coming in the ring, all right, from the top rope.
And I think personally Orndorff deserves everything he gets because Bobby Heenan treated this guy fairly. He took him to the top. He took Mr. Wonderful from nowhere into a household name. And how does Orndorff reward him? He fires Heenan, not once, twice.
Please, I think we've seen enough of Mr. Rude. I'm not too sure if Orndorff has or not. Chris Curtis put in the power driving position.
This he does do well, though. I'll say this, Orndorff.
What a power driver.
Delivers what might be the nastiest power driver in the wrestling business.
Here's Mr. Wonderful.
Rick Rude looking on. And Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Orndorff going out. Wait a minute. No, he's getting a little first-hand look now at ravishing Rick Rude. I think maybe we just might see Orndorff strike a post. There we go. Fans certainly show their approval.
What an egomaniac.
All right, here's more on some upcoming World Wrestling Federation events.
upset, Moolah, when I beat you for the title in Houston, Texas. It was no major upset. It was destiny because of the fact people expect sensational things from me. Our paths will cross again in the Survivor Series Thanksgiving night. Then we'll find out how much of an upset that it was.
Tell him, Honky, tell him.
I've proved two things. I've proved that I'm the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time, and I've proved that I'll do anything to keep this belt around the waist where it rightfully belongs. And if anybody gets in my way, anybody, that means you, Elizabeth. If you think you got hurt last time when I shoved you down, you just try stepping in front of me again, and you'll get hurt a lot worse. And as far as you macho man, I don't think you heard my tune like it needs to be played. I'm going to play it for you one more time.
It is coming up on Thursday evening, November 26th, Thanksgiving night, the Survivor Series. And here to talk about the main event, Survivor Series, manager Bobby the Brain Heenan, and the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. Well, what's going down and what's going to happen? He's the captain of one team, and on that team is going to be the natural Butch Reed, ravishing Rick Rude, the one-man gang, King Kong Bundy, and the eighth wonder of the world, and the uncrowned heavyweight champion, Andre the Giant. And on the other team is going to be that ex-con, Ken Patera, superstar Billy Graham, Bam Bam Bigelow, and that ingrateful, backstabbing Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and the captain of that team, the idiot that's so controlling it all, is none other than the World Wrestling Federation World Heavyweight Champion, Hulk Hogan. But you see, Hogan is going to be hiding behind everybody. But eventually, Thanksgiving night, Andre the Giant, who has not been near a ring, in a ring, or wrestled since WrestleMania 3, is going to get his hand on that 310-pound turkey named Hulk Hogan. As we get away with Andre now, but
help yourself.
Okay, you just heard about that terrific lineup on the other side, Andre.
I will tell you one thing. I always tell to that Survivor Series, just the one thing I put in, because you cheated on me for the championship last night. But this is not a championship match. This is a Survivor. And you got the best in the Survivor. And I told you, I promised one thing to Bobby Heenan. I will be the Survivor. Because the Bobby Heenan family are the best. That's why we're coming there, and we're going to stay the best. And Bobby, I promise you that we're going to get out of that ring with a great victory. Because we deserve it. Honor your children. Get in the ring. And bring me once in a week in the match, just me and you, one and one. But Hogan, no way to go this time, because you have to be pinned 1, 2, 3 in the middle. That's the way you have to get out of the ring, and that's the way you're going to get out.
You see, every time someone's defeated, they have to leave. Eventually, Hogan, it's going to boil down to this man and you. And if you think he was ready in WrestleMania 3, well, you're thinking wrong. Because he was ready, but not ready like he's going to be Thanksgiving night. And there's only going to be one survivor. And that survivor is going to be our team. And the man left standing is going to be the eighth wonder of the world, the uncrowned world champion, your champion, Andre the Giant. So Hogan, you better start hiding. The turkey is all over.
Yeah, won't you jump in? Your path and my path are gonna cross real soon, yeah. And to forgive and to forget, those are words that aren't in the Macho Man Randy Savage's dictionary. Oh, no, not at all, yeah. What you did to me with the guitar over your head, yeah. Crashing down on top of me like a piano, yeah. I will never forget what you did, yeah. What you did to my manager, yeah. I will never forgive. No. I will never forgive what you did to Elizabeth. I will never forgive, yeah. Taking her and shoving her down like that and standing over her like the hot dog that you are. You will pay for that, because I will never forgive you, and you're in the exact middle of the danger zone.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my left, introducing the manager, Oliver Humperdinck. He represents from Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. His opponent, to my right, is managed by Bobby the Brain Heenan. Weighing 275 pounds, here is Hercules.
Tremendous matchup inside the ring here at the Mecca Arena in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, as we have Hercules battling Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Hello, everyone. Bruce Pritchard at ringside, along with the always lovely Mike McGirt. And joining us this week, Leaping Lanny Poffo. As you saw in the introductions, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, very anxious, is the referee now trying to grab that ever-present chain away from Hercules. And Lanny, that can be a very dangerous weapon.
That's right, as you just saw, Bobby the Brain Heenan, sneaky little weasel that he is, distracted Mr. Wonderful. And now, as you can see, he is really stomping him down.
And Hercules taking full advantage, putting the boots to Mr. Wonderful. And Bobby Heenan may be trying to take advantage on the outside, but Oliver Humperdinck was there, Mike.
Yeah, it looked like we're going to have manager against manager here.
Indeed, no love lost between Bobby the Brain Heenan and Oliver Humperdinck. Two very successful managers here in the World Wrestling Federation. And Hercules now with the knee to Mr. Wonderful, sending him right back to the outside. And not a good place for Mr. Wonderful to be, Lanny.
That's right, no love lost at all between Bobby Heenan and Paul Orndorff, because twice already, Paul Orndorff has fired Bobby Heenan.
Now Hercules sending Paul Orndorff over the top rope, but Mr. Wonderful holding on.
Surprise, look here.
Maybe Hercules a little bit too confident.
Somebody's home.
Going to work on Hercules in the corner, and Hercules reverses, and Orndorff reverses again. High knee at that time by Paul Orndorff, and right now Orndorff seems to have the upper hand, Lanny.
You know, Bruce, Orndorff has an advantage here, especially when it comes to Heenan, because he knows all those tactics since Heenan himself is taught him. So he's got the upper hand.
And Orndorff that time, introducing Hercules into that canvas. And a pretty even matchup at this point. And a rake right across the eyes as Paul Orndorff, very familiar with the rule-breaking moves, Lanny.
That's right, there's been a lot of contingencies in the match so far, but I must say that Hercules would do well to keep his eye on Paul Orndorff and not turn his back on his opponent. As you can see, moments ago, there was a skin the cat performed with suspended animation. Now Sir Oliver Humperdinck giving advice to his man, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
And along with the capacity crowd's approval. Oh, just to be met by that.
And Hercules firing off a couple right hands right to the jaw of Mr. Wonderful. And the tide has changed. Clothesline by Hercules, and now Hercules going for the cover. Not enough to keep him down.
Very arrogant body press. Now he's getting a little more serious, but that's not enough for Mr. Wonderful.
That time Hercules hooked the leg, but it still wasn't enough to keep Mr. Wonderful on the mat for the three count. This capacity crowd here in Milwaukee getting behind Mr. Wonderful, shouting him that extra added encouragement. And Orndorff with a blow to the throat area of Hercules. Hercules stops him with a knee lift to the midsection. Not a good place right now for Paul Orndorff to be as Hercules puts the pressure on with devastating bear hug.
Hercules has a lot of strength, but unfortunately, all his brains are in the corner. And by that, I mean the manager, Bobby Heenan. He manipulates Hercules just like a marionette.
Indeed, Bobby the Brain Heenan has fired all of his main charges at one Paul Orndorff. He has had them all go after one by one. And tonight, it is Hercules. But there is no love lost between the Heenan family and Paul Orndorff and Oliver Humperdinck.
That's true, and even now as we speak, the Weasel is sneaking around. You've got to keep your eye on him at all times.
Bobby Heenan on the outside of the ring trying to get the timekeeper to ring the bell, saying that Paul Orndorff was ready to submit, but I don't buy that for a second. And Paul Orndorff, the cheers of the crowd here.
I must say that a tactic like that wouldn't work on Dave Hebner. He's a no-nonsense referee. Any skullduggery like that would be quickly thwarted.
And Orndorff that time broke the bear hug, and he hasn't cradled. This may be it.
No, no.
Not enough to hold the big man down, Mike.
You've got both two big men in there, and it's going to be a battle in the end. Of course, you've got the Heenans. That's another battle in itself.
Orndorff with the clothesline, nice maneuver.
Oh.
Nice knee lift that time by Paul Orndorff. Bobby Heenan on the outside of the ring looking a little bit worried.
An amazing aerial dropkick by Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff, and he is going to the top rope.
Time. And Paul
Orndorff
for the pile driver.
Now we have it.
Makes his way to the apron only to be met by the right hand from Paul Orndorff.
Well, he shouldn't have been on the apron anyway, Bruce, and he should have been met by that. He should be down there at all times.
And Orndorff delivers a pile driver to Hercules, and this could be it. And in the ring, Rip Rude.
Oh, no.
Has made his way to ringside and is putting the boots to Mr. Wonderful.
And the crowd is up on its feet, Bruce. Do you all see this? Oh.
And Rude there meets Orndorff with the clothesline. The referee only.
Well, he has a developed hatred for Orndorff, doesn't he?
The referee has called for the bell as Rick Rude going to work on Paul Orndorff, throws him on the outside of the ring.
Please. Oh.
And the ravishing one, Rick Rude, strikes a pose on the inside while his manager, Bobby Heenan.
And Rick Rude does not have any friends in Milwaukee, Wisconsin tonight.
No.
Dina, we'll take you up to ringside right now for
the
official
word. I don't
know if he
has any friends anywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee's official decision, he awards the bout as a result of a disqualification to Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, the winner of the match, there he is, Paul Orndorff. With that cane that Oliver Humperdinck carries to the ring, and Orndorff is fired up. Right now, we're going to take a look at the replay of exactly how it all happened. Paul Orndorff fires off at Bobby Heenan. And he goes for the pile driver. Gets Hercules up and delivers.
That's one to be reckoned with, that hole right there. Yeah, and there you see.
Ravishing Rick Rude causing the outside interference, putting the boots to Mr. Wonderful right there, causing the disqualification.
Rick Rude,
winner of the match.
I call you a man. If there's any man in you,
Paul Orndorff has a
chance. Get your butt in this ring and face me.
Mr. Wonderful issuing a challenge for Rick Rude to come back into the ring right now.
It's not over yet.
One-on-one. We said earlier, no love lost between these two men, Lanny. And Paul Orndorff will be ready for ravishing Rick Rude anytime in any place.
Get on board.
The winner of the match by disqualification, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. For Mike McGurk and Leapin' Lanny Poffo, this is Bruce Prichard. Don't go away. We'll be back with more World Wrestling Federation.
And his opponent from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 288 pounds, George the Animal Steele.
Look at the fur. Look at the hair all over this man. George the Animal Steele. Look at this. Here we go. Honky Tonk Man heads for cover.
You know, I do question the Honky Tonk's choice of wrestling animal Steele. Question it because Honky Tonk Man's the Intercontinental Champion. He's got many great title defenses coming up in the near future, and to put his body on the line against this madman Steele is beyond belief to me.
What are you saying, that as a champion should be choosing about his opponents?
Well, this is a non-title matchup. The title's not on the line.
So what?
Animal Steele does not know a rule book or a rule in wrestling at all.
Since when you worry about rules?
In 1 week's time, on Saturday, October 31st, it's going to be a super night of World Wrestling Federation action at the Centrum in Worcester. Among those on the card, you'll see the British Bulldogs, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, the One Man Gang, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, and many more of your favorites at the Centrum in Worcester in 1 week's time, Saturday, the 31st of October.
This match could well come down to brain power, and if that's the case, Honky will win it.
Look at this! George Steele messing up that greasy kid stuff! Has him way high in the air! Drops him down like a sack of potatoes! The Animal comes off of the shoulder block! Look at that nasty green tongue flapping back and forth. Animal to the rope.
Wait a minute.
Jimmy Hart had to hook an ankle.
Oh!
Jimmy Hart's gonna pay! The jacket of Jimmy Hart.
Wait a minute, what's the Honky Tonk doing? Oh no.
The Animal.
Whoa.
They're going to disqualify Steele.
No way they had to disqualify.
I love it. I told you if it got down to brains, what would happen.
Cole. They set him up.
They set him up great.
The referee has awarded this bout as a result of their to the Honky Tonk Man.
The Animal going after a Honky Tonk Man and Jimmy Hart. The Animal very upset over what happened to Elizabeth several weeks ago. And Honky Tonk Man got to get out of time. The Animal tear everything up.
Look at this guy.
There goes the bell. Here he comes. He's coming after him.
There, you just saw a classic example of brains over brawn. The thinker will always beat the meathead. And there's a classic meathead right there.
Well, certainly it looked like Intercontinental Champion the way
going
out
for
of there like a coward.
I bet he's going for lunch here.
Well, I wouldn't think so. And we have a replay. George Steele.
Now look at this. Here's Steele. Now watch what happens. Here's the Honky Tonk Man. He hits Steele first in the back while the referee's being distracted. And here he gets hit. Boom, right in his back. And down he goes.
But the question is, who distracted the referee? Steele did.
The point is that here's Steele now does the same thing to the Honky Tonk Man, and he's disqualified for it.
Let's go back to the arena, and the Animal is doing just that. He's having a little lunch. There's only one mocking, George the Animal Steel. Let's take you now, ladies and gentlemen, courtesy of Saturday Night Main Event, to a special update on Andre the Giant and his participation in the King Kong Bundy Call
for a 247-pound Mike Richards. And his opponent, let's walk the ring by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 250 pounds, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Ravishing. What perfect music for Rick Rude to just roll by and show that body to all these women here.
You think they're interested?
I definitely think they're interested. I mean, this guy's a lady's dream. Not only does he have a body, he's got a face to go with it. Look at there.
Is that a lady? I think he's, come on, let's wrestle. Look at that look. He is so into himself. Can you believe that?
There's look at all the cameras. Shot. I'll say this, you never saw flash bulbs going like that when Bruno took his robe off.
Bruno never wore a robe.
Five, too bad.
Ladies, that was just a sample of the sexiest body in the world. So what we need to have right now is for all the fat beer belly construction workers, keep the notice out while I take my robe off so your ladies can give me their complete and undivided attention.
Complete undivided attention, huh?
There's a guy who's in love with himself.
Oh, there's no question about that.
Well, what better person is there to be in love with than yourself?
What a case of
heart. Look at that. Look at that.
Oh, one more treat for everybody here on your humanoid. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce right now the biggest member of the Bobby Heenan family. At 7'5",
oh, no.
525 pounds, the eighth wonder of the world, and the next heavyweight champion of the world, Andre the Giant.
Look at the size of that man.
Maybe Andre's going to pose with Rude.
If Andre stood in front of Rude, you wouldn't see Rude. Andre the Giant. The catalyst behind his team in the Survivor Series.
You know what's great? The show of unity. Out comes Andre just simply to watch Rick Rude wrestle. I mean, that's got to be a thrill for Rude, having the eighth wonder of the world coming out just to watch him wrestle.
Ravishing Rick Rude, recently signing with Bobby the Brain Heenan. That was well documented in the WWF magazine. Look at that. Double bicep shot.
Listen to the screams from the girls in the crowd.
Is that why they were screaming?
Oh.
Despite Rude being in love with himself, you have to give credit where it's due. Rick Rude is a consummate professional wrestler. He can mix it up with the best of them. And Rick Rude, despite... Wait a minute, what's happening over here? There's a man who can mix it up. That man. You recall last week when Rick Rude came out and interfered in Paul Orndorff's match. Paul Orndorff has given it to Rick Rude. Wait a minute, covered up man, two and... Oh, we almost got him.
Well, I'll tell you.
Struck it by Orndorff.
Obviously, Orndorff's ego's gotten the best of him. He's going after fan approval.
Maybe not. Maybe he's just trying to distract Rick Rude. Let Rick Rude have a little dose of his own medicine, so to speak. Heartbreaker, let you do it. Richards down to the canvas, and let's get the official decision.
The winner of this contest, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, I could see there's going to have to be a showdown somewhere along the line between these two. The pot's boiling now.
Hey, Mr. Wonderful. I want you to take a good, hard look at what Simply Ravishing is all about.
That's what Ravishing is all about. We might be able to.
Yeah, that's what Wonderful is all about.
All right. Let's take you now, ladies and gentlemen, and give you some information on upcoming World Wrestling Federation events.
Come on, girls.
We are the Glamour Girls, and welcome to our world.
That's right, Jimmy Hart's Glamour Girls, the WWF Women's Tag Team Champions. They're rough and they're tough. They're sexy. They're glamorous. They're beautiful. But most of all, they're the champs. Jimmy Hart's Glamour Girls.
For the big event, Thanksgiving night, the Survivor Series, a series of elimination battles in tag team divisions, singles competition, ladies and men. And among the competitions, Andre the Giant's team will battle against Hulk Hogan's team. But for now, we're going to talk about the tag team division, and that's why we've assembled these five managers up here to talk about a very terrific tag team division, Jimmy.
Let me just say this, baby. The Hart Foundation, the World Tag Team Champions, we're going to be ready. That's all I got to say, Daddy, in the Survivor Series.
A lot of competition on the other side. The Young Stallions, Killer Bees, Rougeau's to name a few.
Well, you know, the Hart Foundation, they're the captains of the team because they're the World Tag Team Champions. And as much as every member here and every manager wants their team to be tag team champions, we're all going to work together to survive in the Survivor Series.
That's right. Remember, this is going to be some of the most fierce action of all time. But when the smoke clears the ring, remember, the wrestling team will stand defiant and strong, Daddy.
You know, one thing I'd like to interject here, there'll be five teams on each side. That's 20 men in this tag team. I understand the ring is going to be reinforced, and what is eventually going to happen, you're going to see the likes of the Killer Bees, the Rougeaus, all those other little wimpy teams get eliminated once and for all.
May I interject this point? Don't forget, also among those tag teams, we have neglected to mention the British Bulldogs. The former World Tag Team Champs will be there, too.
That's right, the British Bulldogs. I know that they want the Hart Foundation, but I promise you this, baby, we're going to come out victorious. Our team's going to come out victorious.
And the funny thing is, if one of my men, the Islanders, is pinned, submits, counted out, or gives up, both Islanders have to leave. The same goes for both the Hart. Same goes for the Rougeaus, any of them. One man's beat, they both leave. But when it's all over, everybody on our side is going to be standing there because we are one thing, gentlemen. We are survivors.
We'll find out Thanksgiving evening, the Survivor Series.
Better to be king than queen, right?
From Turkey,
all depends on who's reigning.
Weighing 275 pounds, Frankie DeFalco.
Frank DeFalco.
You know, I think it would be a very polite gesture if everybody got out of their seat and showed proper respect by bowing to the King, Harley Race. Just hang on. I said, get up off your chairs and show some respect.
Could you believe Heenan actually thought he was having mic problems when everyone didn't stand up and bow?
I think Justice is the only one who stood up.
No, there's a few over in the corner there, Bruno. No,
I don't see anybody.
I don't see him now. Look at the king, treating that crown as if it really means something. It does.
It does mean something.
Only to him. First, I must say he won it fair and square. A little over a year ago, a series of King of the Ring tournaments. Harley Race.
What I like about Harley Race is the methodical way he takes opponents apart.
He's a tactician.
No wasted moves.
Matter of fact, we had an occasion to chat with the King Harley Race a little bit before his match. Here's what he had to say.
As you've seen before, and you'll see again, and this will be no exception. Every one of my opponents will eventually bow to the king.
I'm not so sure of that. DeFalco, big man. Uh-oh. Takes a headbutt from the King Harley Race.
DeFalco's 275 pounds, but so far he's provided no opposition whatsoever for Harley Race. Harley's been just too clever for him.
Look at that.
Whoa. Nice suplex.
The King. You know, he really is into himself.
He's not done with his subject yet.
His subject?
Yeah. Oh,
here
yeah,
it comes.
The cradle suplex. Love that move.
That's quite a maneuver. Now, King. It's the Duke. Stars who would like to crown the king, all right?
But not many very capable of doing it, is there? The crown's still on top of his head.
Yeah.
That speaks for itself.
Look at this. What's this now? He wants DeFalco to bow. Oh, you're kidding me.
Oh, I love it.
Wants him to bow again.
Blame the guy. I mean, he don't want to get suplexed no more, does he?
Scheduled next, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. We're going to have some fun when he arrives on the scene out there. Duggan scheduled to wrestle next, and the King, believe it or not, still basking in his regalness. Oh, here it comes. Whoa.
Problem here.
Just listen to what they're saying. The King is standing in the way of Duggan.
No, he's not. There's plenty of room for Duggan to go around him. Oh,
whoa.
What a cheap shot that was. He hit the King with the 2x4.
The King wants to get in the ring.
I don't blame him. What a cheap shot that was.
Look at that. That wasn't a cheap shot at all.
What's wrong with you? What are you talking about?
Let's go for the replay real quick. Follow me in the matchup.
You're going to see right here how Harley Race is the guy who
You're
starts.
Not calling
Look
this
at
a
this.
Cheap shot?
No,
Look at
he
this.
Just pushed Duggan. Harley Race started it.
Oh, my.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Pleasant Falls, New York, weighing 280 pounds, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. His opponent from Korea, weighing 271 pounds, Tiger Chung Lee.
Tiger Chung Lee. Harley Race still wants to get back into the ring. Tiger Chung Lee and Hacksaw Jim Duggan going at it. Duggan with a nice reversal. Tiger Chung Lee off. Bird body drop. Nicely done.
Again, we remind our area fans that on the 31st of October, it's the Centrum in Worcester for Great World Wrestling Federation action. And then Sunday, November 1st, a 1:30 p.m. starting time, it's great action in Portland, Maine, when the WWF comes to the Cumberland County Civic Center.
Duggan off the other one in a scoop. Big Hacksaw Jim Duggan holds him up there and pumps him down with a slam. Nicely done. King wants to come back in. But here comes Thurgood, shoulder block in the clothesline. A cover. And a count of three. Wait a minute, here comes the King. The King's coming back down.
We're going to have some major problems, I think.
Tiger Chung Lee on his way out. And Duggan has in his hand at 2x4.
And look at the King. The King is not armed with anything.
He's looking for Bobby Heenan. That's what he's looking for. Here comes a chair.
Oh, now whoa, it's even.
Oh, boy. Just hit. Let's maintain. Get him out of there. Get him out of there. Harley Race wants to get back in there. Get him back. Let's get the official word.
Uh-oh.
What's gonna happen here? You gotta be kidding me.
The whole world's gonna tune in and watch Dangerous Danny Davis in single competition for the first time on TV. Now, I know you people out there are all expecting me to lose. Well, forget about it, because I'm gonna write a new chapter in the history of professional wrestling.
This bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring from Tampa, Florida, weighing 230 pounds, Terry Gibbs. And his opponent, weighing in at 271 pounds, the Ultimate Warrior.
Ultimate Warrior making his debut here on Wrestling Challenge. Take a look at that body.
Okay, the guy's put together.
He certainly is. He's a whole lot bigger than Ravishing Rick, too.
What's he doing? This guy's not all there either.
You mean, are you implying that Ravishing Rick is not all there?
No, I meant the Duggins and people like that.
Well, that's the implication I got from your statement.
That's not what I meant.
Terry Gibbs, a ring veteran, getting an awakening here. Look at the size and power of the Ultimate Warrior and the agility.
Oh. One arm.
One arm hip lock took him over with a whole lot of height on it, too. This guy's got any kind of wrestling experience and ability, he is going to be a handful.
Talk about off the wall.
Some funny markings as well. You know, earlier on, I had a chance to ask the Ultimate Warrior a very simple question, what he expected out of the... He wasn't at a loss for words.
Fans out there looking for some type of direction. You came to the right place, brother, because you're looking at the Ultimate Warrior. Look real deep in my eyes and jump on my back, because I'm going to take you through the wall. And when you look at these veins, the only thing that flows through these veins is the power of the Warrior.
The power of the Warrior flowing through those veins. Oh, what a clothesline. Giving a signal here, which would indicate to me a press slam coming up. Look at that. Look at that awesome physique. Puts Hercules in rude to shame. Big splash. Gibbs is out of it. Is this guy impressive? The answer, yes.
The winner of this bout, the Ultimate Warrior.
Ultimate Warrior victorious here in his debut on Wrestling Challenge. Something for you to be worried about, Brain.
Upcoming on Thanksgiving night, it's the Survivor Series,
And I don't think there will be a busier man than the man I'm going to introduce you to, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. And Jimmy, I think you're going to have to forget about the turkey, forget about the cranberry sauce this year. You're going to be a busy man on Thanksgiving night.
Well, you know, like you said, baby, who is the business manager in the... And why am I? I'll tell you why. Because you see, baby, I manage champions. You see, you know, out of the three matches, I'm so excited about what's coming up on Thanksgiving, man. I feel like an elephant sitting on my tongue out here. But I am involved in three out of the four matches, Daddy.
That's right. Now, let's go over them one by one. Okay, first of the women's division, you'll be managing on one side.
That's right. Sensational Sherry's going to be the captain on one side, Moon on the other side. But on Sensational Sherry's ring, can you believe that's who she's got, baby? She's got Jimmy Hart's Glamour Girls, the women's tag team champions, Daddy.
Hold on a minute. You know what you just said? The Fabulous Moolah, perhaps the greatest ladies wrestler ever.
Well, this is 1987, not 1957, baby. We're going to be victorious.
All right, let's move up one step. In the singles competition, what a great matchup there.
That's right. Can you imagine this, man, on the singles? Like you said, baby, the honky-tonk man on one side of the ring, Randy Macho Man Savage on the other side of the ring. Can you believe this? Captains of their team.
There's a lot of other people supporting, of course, Randy Macho Man Savage, including, among others, the Junkyard Dog, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Jake the Snake will be there.
But don't look at Honky Tonk's team, man. Look who we've got. King Harley Race, Hercules, Dangerous Danny Davis. And don't forget, look who else we've got on there too, baby. A surprise secret, Daddy.
All right, we left out the tag team division, and you know how the British Bulldogs, the Rougeaus, they'll be gunning to get you.
That's right, but look at this. The Hart Foundation, the tag team champions managed by the Mouth of the South, and look who we've got. The Demolition, the Dream Team, the Russian, and the Islanders.
You know something? I forgot one thing. Matilda will be on the other side. You know she likes to get at you, too.
That's right, but I'm going to take care of Matilda myself, and you can bank on that. But let me tell you something, Bulldogs. We want you as bad as you want us, and we're going to get you. Savage, you ain't seen nothing yet, the honky-tonk man. We're after you, baby. That's a promise.
All right, thank you very much, Matt and the South, Jimmy Hart. Looking forward to seeing you in the Survivor Series on
Ladies and gentlemen, we have heard about him for some time now. He claims everybody's got a price. Introducing, led by his bodyguard, Virgil, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase. Everybody's got a breath.
Well, 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 the million-dollar man is here. And as you can all see, I'm accompanied by my man, Virgil. And in one hand, Virgil has a basketball. Poor man's sport, basketball, right, Virgil? It's very easy to play basketball. All you need is a ball, a hoop, and an old raggedy pair of tennis shoes. Not like the expensive games that I play. They take Lear jets, limousines, but that's another story. And in the other hand, Virgil has just a small sampling of the million-dollar man's millions. And I know that looks like a lot of money to most of you people. And as I look around the crowd, it's obvious to me that most of you would do just about anything for a little bit of my money. And I'll tell you what, being the generous individual that I am, I'm going to give somebody here the opportunity. Look at that, Virgil. Look at the hands waving already. They all want a shot at the money. I'm going to give somebody here the opportunity to make some of my money. Now, all you got to do to make some of my money tonight is bounce the ball. Now, I know that's real difficult for most of you people because you can't chew gum and walk at the same time, but all you got to do is bounce the ball. Now, who wants to make $500? Look at that, Virgil. Look at the poverty. Let's look around here. Let's see who we're going to pick here. Let me see. Okay, we got us a little basketball player right here. Security, let's bring him up here. Bring him up here, right here. Come right on up here, son. Okay, get around here where I can see you now. What's your name, son? Sean. Okay, Sean. Can you dribble a basketball? You can dribble a basketball, okay. Virgil, give him the basketball. Now let me see, can you dribble that basketball 10 times? Let me see you dribble the basketball 10 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Oh. Okay, pick the ball up, Virgil. Well, I'll tell you what I'm going to do, Sean. If you can dribble this basketball 15 times consecutively without missing, look at here, I'm going to give you $500. Now, I know you and your family could use $500. I can tell by looking at you that you could use a lot more than 500 bucks. Okay. Virgil, give him the basketball. Okay, Sean, 15 times. Ready? Go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oops! Oh. We didn't get to 15, Sean. You didn't get to 15, did you? No, he didn't make 15. And you know what that means? What that means, Sean, is you've got to learn a hard, cruel fact of life. When you don't do the job right, you don't get paid.
Fall. Introducing first to my left, both men from the state of California, at a total combined weight of 474 pounds. Introducing first, Lance Allen.
Big boy.
His partner, Sonny Rogers. Their opponents are managed by the Dr. Style Slick. And here is Slick's new tag team combination. Both men hail from the Soviet Union and have a total combined weight of 589 pounds. Introducing Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov, the Bolsheviks.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the request of the Doctor of Style, he would ask you all to please rise and respect Mr. Zhukov's waving of the Soviet flag and Mr. Volkov's singing of the Soviet national anthem.
You know, I noticed a little up-tempo on that song. He's put it to a little bit more rock and roll beat, I think.
I think maybe, yes, very well be.
You know, Billy Joel just got through touring Russia, so, you know, they probably uplifted their anthems a little, make it a little more rock and roll.
Boris Zhukov and Nikolai Volkov teaming up.
Well, one thing's for sure, these two don't have to worry about beefcake and a haircut.
No, they don't. I don't think they have too much to worry about anyhow. Look at the size of Volkov and the size of his partner, Zhukov. Big boys, big powerful men.
Oh, yeah, Slick. You know what amazes me? Slick finds huge guys. Everybody in Slick's stable is a big man.
Good fight.
This Volkov, he's so rough, he's so vicious. I was surprised he used that double chicken wing suplex and he executed it very nicely. Which, like I've been saying all along, the guy can really wrestle, but he chooses to go in there and just maim his opponents. Look at this Zhukov, every bit as vicious. Look at him, big, powerful man.
You know what amazes me? Look at the size of Zhukov's head.
He does have a big head.
I mean, he's got a huge head.
Yeah, and a big body to go with it. He's a big man.
Nikolai Volkov.
Whoa, whoa.
Look at that, another form of a suplex.
Boy, that's two suplexes already.
Well, that's one thing, you know, the Russians are always well-schooled in amateur wrestling. Some of the greatest amateur wrestlers in the world come out of the Soviet Union.
That's true.
Zhukov.
And it's nice to see the Soviets adapt their style to the American freestyle professional wrestling.
Ooh. Zhukov and Volkov taking care of business.
They're not even giving these guys a chance to breathe.
Allen takes more punishment into the back. Big man Lance Allen. And the Doctor of Style looking on. Ooh, to the buckle. Ooh.
Well, you know, it just goes to show. You can be a bodybuilder, but that doesn't always make you a wrestler.
Here's Volkov firing up. Quick hands possessed by Nikolai Volkov.
Very quick hands. You know, for a guy that's over 300 pounds, he does move. Look at this now. Here comes Zukov. What a kick right in the ribs.
Oh, come on, Raph, turn around. Look what he's doing to his face.
Now he'll have to break.
Zukov reaching for the tag. Frequent tag made by Volkov and Zukov.
Ooh. They do like those big kicks, don't they?
I think the Doctor of Style likes it as well. Into a cover. We get one. Come on.
He hasn't had enough yet.
Come on, what?
I think Volkov could have very well pinned Lance Allen.
Nothing in the rules says you have to go for a pin.
Well, especially when they got the opponent hurt so bad. They know he can defend himself, so now they're just going to punish him, torture him, before they take good old time in beating him.
What's the matter with that?
Baloney, what's the matter with
you
that?
You never did that, huh?
No, that's right, never did that.
You never punished or hurt an opponent.
But when I felt I had him beat, I beat him. I wouldn't do this. This is ridiculous.
Coming over to help out his partner, the cartwheeler on the part of Volkov. I don't know who that was supposed to impress. Allen getting up very slowly.
It impresses me watching a guy 6'5", 300 and some pounds do a cartwheel.
Oh, hey, this guy's very athletic. He was quite an Olympic lifter, too.
Well, obviously, when the referee's back was turned, Zukov was doing a number on Lance Allen. Allen entering the ring very slowly. Oh, no! Snapping him off the top rope.
And that's smart wrestling. Use everything at your disposal. Those ring ropes are there. Why not use them?
Boy, this... Look at this Zukov. I was going to say, Vince, he's every bit as vicious as Volkov, huh?
Maybe even more so.
Yeah, maybe even more so is right.
Ooh. Snapping him back. Tremendous damage being done by the suplex, but... No. Tag is made here. Volkov back in. Wide open Lance Allen. Knee to the shoulder area. Tag is made. These Bolsheviks are really tearing apart for Lance Allen.
But Allen, he doesn't know where he's at right now.
Whoa, he headbutted him. I think he caught him with his head. I want to see that on the replay. I think he came off those ropes and drove that big skull right into the man's head.
The winners of this bout, the Bolsheviks!
Nikolai Volkov and Zukov is now, we'll go back and take a little closer look.
Boy, it took about a team to reckon with. Here's Volkov as he whips Zukov, and look at his Zukov, right. He came up. Boy, what a blow. I don't know, did he catch him with his head? I thought he caught him with the forearms or fists.
On to victory, Zukov. And Nikolai Volkov, the Bolshevik. We'll be right back with more World Wrestling Federation action.
Here we go. This is the tag team match scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring area, led by their manager, Mr. Booking, at a total combined weight of 577 pounds, X-Smash Demolition.
Demolition.
These two monsters, and they're just that.
You know, I love the Demolition theme song. I like that. It's a good driving heavy metal beat.
Yeah, you would like that, being into heavy metal.
Bruno, you ever listen to metal music?
No.
That's Smash in there. That's what he's doing right now against young Brady Boone, who's quite a talent in the World Wrestling Federation. He gives it his all, I'll tell you that.
Boone is a very good talent. So is Casey. But I'll tell you, against these two guys, I don't
look
know.
Look at that. Scott Casey tagged in.
Yeah, but you know, sometimes giving your all just ain't good enough.
Ooh.
Brady Boone, we're told, is the cousin of Billy Jack Haynes. We had an occasion to ask Billy Jack Haynes about that a little bit earlier this week. Here's what Billy Jack had to say.
You know, beautiful people, I'm proud and honored to be in the World Wrestling Federation. And I'm also very proud and honored that my cousin Brady Boone has made it in the World Wrestling Federation. Brady, all those, the hours, the agony you spent in the gym, in my Oregon City gym training, along with the help of Ken Patera. You know something, Brady? Us Oregon boys stick together. I love you, cuz.
What a great future this Brady Boone must have, being the cousin to Billy Jerk Haynes and being trained by Ken Patera. Trained what, to do time in the jug?
Wait just a minute. How about trained, obviously, in terms of strength? Ken Patera, certainly at one time, and still remains one of the strongest men in the world today.
The Nassau Coliseum, Uniondale, Long Island, New York, this Friday night, November the 6th, a Super World Wrestling Federation spectacular, including the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, when he meets the Junkyard Dog. Killer Khan will battle Bam Bam Bigelow, and then the one-man gang gets another opportunity to wrest the heavyweight championship from Hulk Hogan this Friday night at the Nassau Coliseum.
They may not be pretty, but they definitely get the job done.
Well, they're not pretty. Action there, hammering away on Scott Casey, trying to make his way over the top. Oh, look at that. Ooh, my. Brady Boone catching on right in the side of the jaw. Back in now is the smash. Finally, Brady Boone tagged in. Look at that maneuver. What a nice maneuver that was by Brady Boone. Boone giving away almost 100 pounds. Off the rope, a scoop from behind. Drop kick in. Brady Boone making quite a counting of himself at the moment. Big smash reverses things off the ropes and elbow. Quick smash almost down. Brady Boone, look at that maneuver. Ha ha! All right! Brady Boone, a one-man. Look at what's going to happen here.
He got caught. He got caught.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ah. Ooh. He couldn't knock that big tree down and it eventually caught him.
Oh, no.
Just too big, too strong, too powerful.
I think they're trying to set him up here. Fuji gets the signal. And hell!
It's all over.
And it's Rico. Fuji yelling at him. What's he yelling?
Fuji's telling he wants more.
Wait a minute. No.
They're going to give it to him again.
Whoa. Oh, come on. There's no call for that.
I think they're going to retire Billy Jack Haynes' cousin here.
Now, this is ridiculous. They won the match. Look at this. They're going for a third one.
Brother. Brady Boone just pummeled.
Look at it like a ball of fire. Look away. He's not putting those big trees down, Jesse.
Well, he ought to. He come in and submarine them, kamikaze them from behind.
Yeah, two against one still. I thought he's in trouble now.
You know what? I like the kissing cousins are eating canvas now.
Oh, no.
Don't tell me this is going to happen to Billy Jack. The militia drops the elbow.
Got Fuji's cane.
Christian destroying everything in sight.
I'll tell you, I am totally impressed with Demolition. I mean, not only did they put Brady Boone out of commission, they took care of Billy Jack Haynes, they took care of Ken Patera. They are just truly awesome in my book.
Well, Patera came in, he's really only got one arm. He did the best he could, but...
Well, then he shouldn't have been in there.
Well, he went in there because of what was going on in there. After all, these are two friends of his.
And the song says it right, walking disaster.
All right, let's take a look now. The destruction that was reaped on one, Brady Boone.
Destruction is right. Now look at this. They got Brady. Oh, listen, I think it's X's team. Now watch. Here comes Smash with the first double. Now this is a 305 man coming raw that way. And as you see, Brady Boone is already down and out. I mean, this man is down. Okay, he's finished. But this doesn't stop there. In a second, we're going to see him do it again. Now look at this. Here's Smash this time, picking up Brady Boone as X goes up on that top rope. And watch as he comes down with all his weight on the neck. And this is a direct blow on the neck of Brady Boone. And here we go.
Boom! And of course, that was the second of three times. Let's go back up to the ring now.
Well, it looks like young Brady Boone's career might be over here.
Could very well be true.
Over before it really got started. Isn't that sad?
You know, he could have broken his neck. Very possible.
Absolutely. After three of those.
You know, I personally would be thoroughly embarrassed to go into the ring on my 2 feet and leave getting carted out on a stretcher.
Let's take you now to the
schedule for one fall. Introducing first the manager, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. He represents from Dover, New Hampshire, weighing 230 pounds, Dangerous Danny Divas.
Well, I'm going to look forward to this match.
And his opponent from Waco, Texas, weighing 228 pounds, Sam Houston.
Sam Houston from Waco, Texas. We'll see what the youngster can do here against Danny Divas.
Footwork for Sam Houston.
Yes, sir. Good-looking young cowboy from Waco, Texas.
There ain't no good-looking young cowboys.
You don't think so, huh?
Nah, they're all goat ropers from Texas.
Stop that, Jesse. All right, now come on. In this matchup, Davis, I believe, put to the test his first time on television.
Uh-huh.
Portland, Maine wrestling fans, it's tomorrow afternoon, and it's the Cumberland County Civic Center for an outstanding World Wrestling Federation card. You'll see Jake the Snake Roberts, the Junkyard Dog, Ravishing Rick Rude, the One Man Gang, and other great stars, superstars of the World Wrestling Federation, all in Portland, Maine, all at the Cumberland County Civic Center tomorrow afternoon, beginning at 1:30 p.m.
Drag takedown, nicely done.
He hasn't done anything because Houston so far hasn't given him a chance to.
You know, why don't you two guys give Danny Divas some credit?
What's that?
I mean, who else in the world could have did what he's done, go from referee to top-notch wrestler in such a short time?
And that's an excellent point. I give you credit for it.
Because no, give Danny Divas credit for it, not me.
All right, but nonetheless, Divas with his cheap tactics. We've seen him with cheap tactics when he was an official, and we certainly see them now as a wrestler. Nice maneuver. Well, the drop kick. We chatted with Danny Divas earlier this week. Here's what he had to say about risking his undefeated streak on television, wrestling single competition.
Are you kidding? You're talking about Dangerous Danny Divas. This is my opportunity to show everybody out there that I know how to wrestle. And do you really believe that I'm thinking of losing?
I don't know if David should be thinking about losing or not. But neither is Houston, I can tell you that. Youngster Sam Houston.
Well, personally, I got to side with Davis in this match.
Really?
I've never met a Texican that I like yet anyway.
Bruno, does that surprise you that...
Jesse is siding with Danny Davis.
Nothing surprised me about Jesse Ventura. All I know is that right now.
Oh, nicely done.
What a nice leg.
I want to see an instant replay on this. Davis is part of the official. Davis is running out of right to be part of the official.
Fuji, his master, teach Killer Khan how to make a pony suffer, how to make him cripple and beg. And also I teach Killer Khan how to strike like Cobra.
Good evening, November 26th, Thanksgiving night, when the World Wrestling Federation presents its Survivor Series, a team concept with an elimination format. In other words, if you get eliminated, you're out, but the team remains alive until all of its members have been eliminated. Now, we've talked about the tag team division, the women's division, and the one where Hulk Hogan's team will battle Andre the Giant's team. But for now, I want to introduce you to my guest, manager of Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and the reigning Intercontinental champ, the Honky Tonk Man. Now, Honky, you are a captain of one team that will battle Randy Savage's team.
I'm the captain of the best team, and the people I've assembled under my tutelage is the King Harley Race, Hercules, Dangerous Danny Davis, and Outlaw Ron Bass. And I can tell you, that is the number one team.
Lest you not forget who is on the other side, Jake Roberts. We mentioned the Macho Man.
That's right. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and of course the captain on the other side of the ring is going to be Randy the Macho Man Savage, right, Honky Tonk?
Hey, you left that Junkyard Dog.
The Junkyard Dog, he's going to be there too, baby. But we're going to come out victorious.
I think you spelled out some team on the other side.
He didn't spell out anything that worries the Honky Tonk Man, because we got it all in the bag. This is what it's all about. The people under me, they've assured me that there's going to be 5-on-1. My team against one man, Macho Man Randy Savage, and I'm going to play that tune for him one more time on Turkey Night.
Thanksgiving evening, I don't know about that, but we will see. Honky Tonk will be the captain of one team against a team led by Randy Macho Man.
All right, here we go. The 10 men over the top rope battle royal. What a match it's going to be. Here we go.
You know, it's virtually almost impossible to call one of these matches because so much goes on at one time with 10 guys in the ring. You got double teaming, you got triple teaming.
The one man is gone.
Unbelievable. I would have expected him to be in at the end.
Yeah, what a shocker. And look at Horton and Morocco, boy. They really went after each other immediately.
Well, I would figure.
Over the top rope, out back, Jack. He's gone.
Outback Jack is out of it.
Outback and the one-man gang are gone. We're down to eight.
Down to eight, and look at... Let's see. My goodness.
You know what the smart concept is in the battle royal like this?
What's that?
In my opinion, to hide out, get in the corners, don't get into conflicts with people. Wait till they eliminate each other, and then you're in there at the end where the money is.
I see. Now to the midsection, Bam Bam Bigelow on Hercules. And an uppercut, Bam Bam taking care of business there. The Warrior holding on to Hercules. Every man for himself! And Nikolai Volkov, oh, wait a minute. The Junkyard Dog follows right after him. Six men left in there. Bam Bam and Zhukov in the corner.
Hercules and Morocco in the fourth round there. And of course, look out here. Ooh, all right, from behind, the ace attacking Morocco.
You know, we're getting to the point now where teamwork could
look at this. Look at the Russian. Take a look at the Warrior.
Yes, look at the big Russian. Look at that clear overhead.
Boom! There he goes. And out. The Warrior scooped over by Orton. Now we're down to three, and the odds aren't too good for Bam Bam. Ace Orton and Hercules. Bam Bam trying to keep his back to the rope.
Well, now we're going to find out just how good Bam Bam Bigelow is.
Look at that maneuver. Bam Bam.
You know, I will say this. It's the first time I've seen Bam Bam Bigelow back up. He's definitely fighting on the defensive right now.
And another maneuver.
He's using his head is what he's doing. He's keeping both guys in
here.
Front of him.
Yes, he is.
Well, that's a smart thing to do.
But they caught him.
Hercules and Orton with Bam Bam. I think they're going to give him a ride. No. He put the brakes on. Now there he goes. Off the rope. Ooh, my double clothesline.
And this is where the double teaming is so important. Here is the one time you can totally double team and it's legal.
That double clothesline would have knocked somebody else out, but look at this guy. He's back up on his feet fighting back.
Bam Bam hammering away. So is Hercules. So is Orton. Trying to soften up the big man. 293 pounds of Bam Bam Bigelow going for the ride. Boom.
And Orton and Hercules' confidence is
growing
now.
Here goes Bam Bam out. Bam Bam.
They can do it. Look at this. They can do it.
He got to the outside. They're both.
I don't believe it. It proves something I always said.
What's that?
It's better to be lucky than good.
You think so? Let's go back now.
Lucky.
Orton in Morocco had Bam Bam cornered over in the corner.
You call this luck. Look at this. They whip Bam Bam to the bottom. Now look at this. Here comes Hercules and Horton. They're both trying to get him over the top rope. They fail. Watch it. Bam Bam really hooks those top ropes, which is a lot of his weight and good leverage.
Watch what he does with the legs, Efren, when he gets to the outside with the legs. Look.
That's right. That's right. And now look at these guys. I guess they're going to think they're going to try a different maneuver or whatever. And look at here now. This takes a little bit of strength. Here's Hercules
above
strength. Right. You better believe it. They threw them both over like they were a couple 90-pound weaklings.
Bam Bam Bigelow, victorious. Stay tuned for more World Wrestling Federation action.
The Hart Foundation, they're the greatest tag team champions of all time, baby.
The Strike Force. What do you do when you're branded? And you know you're a sissy.
The Strike Force. They think they're good enough, but they're not.
The champs.